WinCC version 8, step-by-step, configuring alarm messages.
In this section, we're going to create our alarm system so that we can generate alarms on our valve and pump fail modes. And we can color code the states so that they're red when they come in, green when they go out. We will be able to go to our alarm menu and acknowledge alarms, as well as go into the history and see the alarm states that have happened. So let's get started. We will start by opening the alarm logging editor. The alarm logging editor is part of WinCC Configuration Studio, so it has the same look and feel as the other editors. Under messages, these are alarm class and subclasses, and you can use these to organize your alarms. So we'll create our own class for our color system. Right click, new message class, and we will call it color system. Under color system, we'll right click and add a new message type, and we'll just call this alarms. Under message blocks, we see that we have different types of information that we can add to our alarm system. System blocks are data that is coming from the SCADA system, like date, time, status, and duration. And you can just check the ones you want now, or you can do it later. Under user text, these are message blocks that contain text, which is customized for each alarm message. And these are things that the user sees when alarms occur. Under message text, we'll use this for our main alarm text. And we're going to change the number of characters so that we can have a more complete message. Process value blocks allow us to associate process values with each alarm message so that we can convey relevant information about the alarm. Going back to our alarm system, we'll create alarm messages from our fail tags for pumps and valves for each color system. On the first line, I will open the tag browser, and I can use my filter to find the tags that we want. So here's all of our fail tags for our red, green, and blue systems. I will lasso to highlight them and just click OK. And it's created alarm messages for each tag. Now we need to add the individual messages for each system. If I scroll over to the message text field, then I can begin adding my message text for each tag. I can use my range features to just pull down and copy this, and then I'm just going to change pump to valve. And then if I highlight both of these and pull down, it copies the same text into each field, and I just have to change the colors. Now going back to look at the properties of our subclass, we can define that these alarm messages that belong to the alarm subclass must be acknowledged by the user. We will also want to set our colors for the different states of alarm. We have came in, went out, and acknowledged. So for the font color, we'll choose white. And then the back color of the alarm coming in, we'll choose red. For going out, we'll set the font to white and the background color to green. For acknowledged, we'll set the font to white and the background to blue. We'll give it a lighter color. You can also set properties of each individual alarm message if you want by going to the properties dialog. Now let's create our analog alarm. We'll go to limits monitoring, and in the work area we have a limit values tab where we associate the tag and assign high and low limits, and we have the messages tab, which is where we configure our messages. So we'll start here under limit values, and I'll add our mix tank level. If you have a filter set, make sure you clear that, and I'll just click OK. So this is a new limit to monitor, and if we just click the triangle there, it will allow me to add higher low limits or same or different values. So I'll just set a high limit. And when I highlight this, and if we look at the properties, we can just give it a message number as long as we give it a unique number, we'll give it 1. It will create a message for us, and we can go to our messages tab and look at that. Notice that there's no message tag here. That's okay because the analog limit monitoring engine is taking care of that. If we scroll down, you can see that it's created our message text for us, and it's going to input the proper values here, the limit that it exceeded and what its actual value is. Of course, you can change this if you want. We can also add this message to our color system class, and so it takes on the properties of our subclass, so it is going to be expected to be acknowledged.
We also need to set the limit at which this high limit alarm will trigger. So we can just go into our comparison value and enter a value, and we'll choose 78. And the last thing you'll want to do is right-click on your messages, and under selection, make sure limit monitoring is checked. If this isn't checked, then your limit monitoring won't work when you're in runtime.
So that's it for now in Alarm Logging Editor. The next step is to go back to WinCC Explorer. Make sure you are not in runtime. Go to Computer and your Project Server. And then we'll go to the Startup tab. Here is where we turn on the alarm system. So we just check it and click OK. If you do this during runtime, you'll have to stop runtime and restart it for it to take effect. Now let's go to our Graphics Designer and we'll open our alarm screen. On our alarm screen, we're going to configure our alarm control. I'll double click, and on the general tab, let's turn off auto scrolling and set it to descending order. On our message lists, we will add our message text and set our numbers the first block. And I'll just click apply and OK. You can see it reformats our alarm control and it gives us more room on our message text. This is because we set the width to 60. I also want to increase the font size. So I'll go back to Properties, go to Font, and set my font size. That'll make it a little easier to see in runtime. Then we'll save. And I want to open my main screen. Double click on my alarm banner there. We'll change our default sorting to descending. And on font, we'll also increase the font size. And I'll make a little room here so that we can see the remainder of the text message. Then I'll click Save. And then we'll just go to runtime to test. And when we're going to runtime, you should see the alarm logging runtime editor being activated. And this is because we turned it on in WinCC Explorer. In runtime, we can test our pump and valve fail alarms by using our pop-up controls. So on valve 1, I'll hit test, and you can see we get our alarm here. I'll reset, and it turns green. We'll test one of the pumps, and there's our green pump fail and our reset. If we go to our alarm screen, we can select these and acknowledge them. They leave our active display. We can go back to the long-term archive list and see a list of alarm activations so we have a complete history of when the alarms come in and go out. We can tell the states of the alarms by the colors. So now let's test our analog alarm.
To do this, we're going to go back to Graphics Designer, and on our standard palette, I'm just going to grab a slider object, and I am going to associate it with our mix tank level tag. And click OK, and we're going to use this to change our value in order to test our high limit alarm that we create. I'm also going to just grab the mix tank level and throw it down here so we can see the level. You may ask why we're not using the tag simulator to change the level to generate the alarm, and it's because the simulator gives all the tags it's keeping up with an uncertain status, and the alarm service doesn't recognize it as a valid value and it will not trigger the alarm. So we can't use the tag simulator for this. So I'm just going to close this, save, and I'm going to refresh runtime. So as I change this and I get above our limit, then you see it has exceeded our limit, it generates the alarm. when we come back down into range, the alarm goes away. We can go to our alarm screen, select the alarm, and acknowledge it. And we can go back to our history and see the history of these alarms.